being asthma, you are also prohibited from attending ministries. And your wife, Evelyn, is likewise prohibited from attending in ceremony. And then the fellows and traditions here in the Philippines, Roderick, you need the husband, you are under obligation to support your wife.
Yes.
Not only your wife, but also the children that God may give you in the future.
Yes.
And your wife, Evelyn, is also under obligation to cooperate with you in all the endeavor that you may do in the future for the benefits of your family. Is that there for both of you?
Yes, it is.
Now, having known of your responsibilities and obligations as husband and wife, are you still interested to proceed with this matter?
Very.
Definitely, yes.
Definitely, yes.
Because you are careful.
Roderick
and Evelyn, knowing of your intention to proceed with this marriage, despite of your obligations and responsibilities as husband and wife, may I now request both of you, together with your sponsors, to please stand up. Kailan si Julio Josefe, ang wa matawag ko nila malingkot, no? Lingkot lang na matawag. Okay, move back right. Okay. Turn forward. A little bit. Roderick and Evelyn, I would like to request both of you to please answer truthfully the following questions. Evelyn, did you come here in your own free will in order to give yourself in love and service to Roderick as his wife?
Yes.
Do you take Roderick here present to be a lawfully wedded husband?
Yes.
Do you promise to love him for the rest of your life?
Yes.
Roderick, did you come here in your own free will in order to give yourself in love and service to Evelyn as her husband?
Yes, sir.
Do you take Evelyn, her present, to be a lawfully wedded wife?
Yes, sir.
Do you promise to love her for the rest of your life?
I think so.
Smile, Dick.
Roderick and Evelyn, may I ask you to please face each other and join your right hands and declare your consent before your family, sponsors, guests, and friends gathered here this morning. Roderick and Evelyn, please repeat after me. Grant us, O Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
To be one heart and one soul.
To be one heart and one soul.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
Poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Roderick and Evelyn, kindly read together this portion. From here up to here.
We believe that by our love, we have not only chosen each other, but God has chosen us for each other. So together we will build a family for Him here on earth.
Roderick and Evelyn, kindly repeat after me. Bless, O Lord.
Bless, O Lord.
These rings.
These rings.
So that we, your servants.
So that we, your servants.
Who wear them.
Who wear them.
May believe in mutual love.
May believe in mutual love.
And in unbroken loyalty.
And in unbroken loyalty.
You hold the rings. Roderick, repeat after me. Evelyn.
Evelyn.
Wear this ring.
Wear this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity to you.
And fidelity to you.
Okay. Roderick.
Roderick.
Wear this ring.
Wear this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity to
and
you.
And fidelity to you.
My dear friends, we have just witnessed the bond of marriage between Roderick and Evelyn. A beautiful reflection of a pure love. I wish them constant health, mutual understanding, forgiveness, peace, and harmony in the relationship. That they may sustain a wonderful bond of marriage through all the years to come. A life together that is willing to share each other's burden and joys with God as a center of the relationship. And now, my friends, by virtue of the authority vested in me by law, calling all here present as witnesses, I will now confirm and seal the bond of marriage which Roderick and Evelyn just contracted. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Take your seats.
Ano ba sa natin?
Four copies.
So, four copies.
By plane or by?
That's by car.
By car. 200 kilometers.
2,000.
2,000. So how many hours?
From Toronto to Alberta? 30 hours drive time.
30 hours?
Yeah.
About Calgary is part of Alberta.
Yes, it is, yeah.
They have a daughter there.
Ah, in Calgary, yes.
Yeah. Before he was living in Toronto.
Yeah, my son lives in Edmonton.
Presently, he is working in Calgary, in a hospital.
Ah, yeah.
And she told me that she has a better salary in Alberta than in Toronto.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Is it true?
Oh, yeah, would be, yeah.
Why?
The economy is different up there, the government, the provincial government. Less taxes.
I see. So workers in Alberta is better paid than in Toronto.
They're better paid, but then there's more. They charge more for different things. The government always takes it back at a different level.
Yeah. So once you are in Alberta, you earn more than in Toronto.
Yeah.
Okay. Roderick and Evelyn, can you stand up? Roderick and Evelyn, you have just affixed your signatures on the legal document which binds you forever. I pronounce you now as husband and wife. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations again. Roderick? That's my own penalty. Even I'll case you blind.
Okay.